Mr.Alpaca, fundamentals in 10 minutes. Since its IPO in September 2020, Unity share took a rocket ride to $168 per share before it plummeted to $82. Now the stock bounces back to around $140. So, is Unity software a good investment? Unity is a game engine launched in 2005. By the time most popular games were running on PCs and consoles, the company decided to enter the niche market of macOS and later iOS and Android that helped them catch the wave of mobile gaming boom. It is used for popular games such as Pokemon Go, Monument Valley, Call of Duty Mobile, and Cuphead, etc. By 2021, more than 50% of all new mobile games are created on Unity. Today, Unity has stretched its borders to a variety of desktop, mobile, console, and virtual reality platforms. The engine can be used to create 3D and 2D games, as well as interactive simulations and other experiences. Its real-time 3D technology has been adopted by industries outside video gaming, such as film, automotive, architecture, engineering, construction, etc. Compared with its major competitor Unreal, Unity is more friendly for beginner developers. It has a larger community with abundant online resources. Its user interface is lighter and less intimidating. Unreal used to have an edge on graphics and light tracing, but the gap is getting smaller. The company currently has three major sources of revenue: Create Solutions, Operate Solutions, Strategic Partnerships, and others. Create Solutions account for 31% of revenue, which is generated from the subscription offers and professional services for individuals, teams, and enterprises. Operate Solutions account for 60% of revenue, which consists of Unity Ads, Unity in-app purchase, and cloud-based services such as hosting and user engagement, voice chat, etc. The remaining 9% is from partnership contracts with hardware, operating system, device providers, etc. through multi-year software development arrangements. Another revenue comes from Asset Store. It is a marketplace where verified partners sell software and tools compatible with Unity Engine. Think of it as App Store for Unity game creators. Unity Solutions have created an ecosystem that helps independent developers and studios create, distribute, and monetize their games. If we look at the smile curve, Unity does not produce games themselves, but it is involved in the two most value-added parts, research, development, design, and marketing. It shows great potential for the company to achieve profitability in the future. Now let's look at the market opportunities. The global gaming market is valued at $175 billion in 2021, and it's expected to continue its momentum at an annual growth rate of 10% for coming years. To put into context, the estimated annual growth rate is 23% for electrical cars and 4% for smartphones. Unity takes 45% of gaming engine market, a big winner in its growing sector. The company is also well positioned to embrace the era of augmented and virtual reality gaming. With accelerated growth rate of 46% per year, AR and VR will very likely become the next tailwind for Unity's future growth. So far, Unity is still regarded mostly as a game engine. If we look at its path over the years, it has already stretched its business boundary far beyond. Let's look at some of its acquisitions over the last 12 months. Fingerfood has greatly enhanced its real-time 3D technology that brings immersive interactive experience. Pixie has further unlocked Unity's advantage in engineering and computer-aided design. SpeedTree makes it possible to model lifelike 3D vegetation for Unity users. Auto is integrated into Unity family to foster a safer and pleasant gaming environment. Parsec allows gaming and creative professionals to work together from anywhere. These acquisitions create a deep moat for Unity's future growth. Speaking of growth, let's put its revenues into four segments: new and existing users in gaming and non-gaming. Currently, most revenues are generated from existing users in gaming, and it grows fast as their current games gain more popularity and they keep developing new games. All these games will need more operation support. Revenues come from new users in gaming are negligible and grow slowly, as 94 of the top 100 game development companies are already working with Unity. Transfer cost from other engines to Unity is high for large developers. Unity is free for independent developers with annual revenues below $100,000. For non-gaming segment, customer scenarios vary greatly with different industry. Unity needs to spend more on research and development or acquisition to find the right solution. At this stage, non-gaming takes only a small percentage of revenue, but it is highly scalable. A good example is automobile industry. All the top 10 automakers work closely with Unity on design, simulation, and marketing projects. Non-gaming sector is expected to grow considerably. Wall Street will soon realize Unity deserves higher valuation as its total addressable market expands. Now let's turn to financials. We are looking at some of Q2 2021 earning highlights. Revenue is registered at 273.6 million, an increase of 48% from Q2 2020. The company has kept consistent growth for last quarters. If we check the breakdown of its three sources of revenue, we could find operate solutions keep increasing as a percentage of total revenue. Loss from operations was 149.2 million, or 55% of revenue. The gap is widened compared with previous quarters. Investors are questioning the time frame of Unity's eventual profitability. As Unity is the only game engine traded in public, we can't directly compare with its competitors. The closest comparison would be Autodesk. Let's look at some of their similarities. While Unity is the leading engine that powers the gaming world, Autodesk is the dominant engine that drives the physical world in architecture, engineering, and construction. They have very similar sources of revenue. From the year 2016 to 2019, Autodesk was struggling to be profitable, but dragged behind by its huge costs and expenses. The revenue has steadily grown. At the same time, cost of revenue and operating expenses decrease as a percentage of total revenue. The company finally achieved profitability by 2020, but the share price has already tripled before that. We expect the same thing would happen to Unity, but even faster. The reason being that Unity quarterly revenue growth is 3 times that of Autodesk. Unity subscription revenue is only a third of Autodesk. Although subscription is a consistent and stable source of cash flow, it has a slower growth rate and lower margin compared with revenue from operate solutions. If we look at Unity's cost and expense breakdown, the increasing cost of revenue and operating expenses were mainly caused by stock-based compensation. It has climbed from 6% pre-IPO to around 30% in recent quarters. We understand some of the employees contributed greatly to the growth of the company, and they deserve being rewarded. This expense is expected to gradually return to normal level. Like Autodesk, its cost of revenue and operating expenses, SBC excluded, will also drop gradually as a percentage of revenue over the years. However, investors should be aware that Unity will not become profitable until 2023, according to Company Outlook. Overall, Unity is a company with following advantages: dominant market position, high growth rate, deep moat. We believe it is a good choice for long-term hold.